Thank you, Chairperson. Today, I'd like to talk about the long-term prognosis of lower urinary tract function after robot-assisted radical prostatectomy in patients with preoperatively low bladder contractility. I have no COI. In previous study, we have identified the predictive factor for postoperative detrusor underactivity, DU, at 1 month after radical prostatectomy, RP. This result shows that preoperative lower bladder contractility index, BCI, was a predictive factor of postoperative DU at after RP. This also suggested that the decrease in reserve capacity of bladder function preoperatively might contribute to the development of postoperative DU in relatively early phase after RP. However, the long-term prognosis of lower urinary tract function and symptom, including voiding and storage, in the patients with lower bladder contractility remained unclear. In this study, we analyzed the time-dependent change of lower urinary tract function and symptom in the patients who underwent robot-assisted RP, RARP. This is a study design. We performed UDS before RARP on 115 patients and assessed the preoperative BCI. We divided the patients into preserved group and impaired group by BCI value, and evaluated maximum flow rate Qmax, voiding volume VV, post-voiding residual volume PVR, 1 hour PAT, IPSS, QOL score, and OIBSS at 1, 3, 6, 9, and 12 months after RARP. Furthermore, in order to determine the risk factors for lower BCI, we performed univariate and multivariate logistic regression analysis by using patient parameters including age, body mass index, prostate weight, diabetes, LDL cholesterol. This table shows patient characteristics in preserved and impaired group. These parameters have no significant differences between two groups. On the other hand, in lower urinary tract symptom parameter, IPSS voiding score was significantly higher in preserved group than impaired group. Here, you can see the result of time-dependent change of lower urinary tract function after RARP. These results show that Qmax at 1, 3, 6, 9 and 12 months and the voiding volume at 3 months was significantly lower in impaired group than in preserved group. This suggested that preoperative lower bladder contractility was associated with prolonged deterioration of voiding function. In addition, these are the result of time-dependent change of lower urinary tract symptom after RARP. These results show that IPSS voiding score at 1, 3, 6, 9, and 12 months were significantly lower in impaired group than in preserved group. This suggested that preoperative lower bladder contractility was associated with prolonged deterioration of voiding symptom. We also analyzed logistic regression analysis of patient parameters related to preoperative lower bladder contractility before RARP. This result showed that high LDL cholesterol was identified as a risk factor for preoperative lower bladder contractility. Furthermore, we performed ROC analysis of LDL cholesterol, predicting preoperative low bladder contractility. In analysis, a cutoff value of 113 offered the optimal accuracy, and AUC was 0.631. Our analysis showed that the patients with low bladder contractility have the deterioration of voiding function for a long period. In addition, dyslipidemia, including high LDL cholesterol, might affect the deterioration of bladder contractility. In conclusion, preoperative low bladder contractility was associated with prolonged deterioration of voiding function. It was suggested that the dyslipidemia might be associated with decrease in bladder contractility. Thank you.